PeopleSoft Travel and Expenses has made many updates from PeopleSoft Update Image 45 through Update Image 48. Some of these features are only available in the Fluid User Interface and not in the Classic version. We'll highlight the features added to the Travel and Expenses modules, pointing out those features that originated in the My Oracle Support idea space. PeopleSoft Travel and Expenses enhanced the expense report, time report, and made updates to provide approvers with more information to support their approval decisions. We'll talk about these enhancements and let you know the image where the feature first appeared. Let's see how to show personal hours details to the approver on the time report. When a manager clicks on the approvals tile on their homepage, all the documents awaiting approval are displayed. As an approver, you can select the time report row in the list and see all the time reports that need approval. You can approve the time report here. If you wish to see the detailed time report, click on the row to see the details. The time report now shows both the time spent on a project activity as well as any personal time. After reviewing, you can elect to approve the time report. To deny, provide the reason so that the subsequent approvers as well as the time reporter can be aware of why a time report was rejected, and then click Deny. The CONUS file load process is updated to include the local incidental expenses. The U.S. Department of Commerce establishes the travel per diem reimbursement rates for the continental United States, or CONUS, which includes the 48 contiguous states and the District of Columbia. Federal agencies use the per diem rates to reimburse their employees for subsistence expenses incurred while on official travel. Federal per diem reimbursement rates consist of a maximum lodging allowance component and a meals and incidental expenses component. In PeopleSoft Update Image 45, we updated the PeopleSoft tables to accept the new meals and incidental expenses data with the updates. Next, let's see how we've enhanced the Pending Approvals Travel Authorization feature. When you select the Approvals tile as an approver, you can see the number of approvals that are waiting for your attention. Once you select the approval that you want to review, you can see a list of documents. In this example, multiple travel authorizations require your attention. For more details on a particular travel authorization, click on that row to open a page with details. The Details page now shows the expense types with a payment flag of Prepaid, which may help with an approval decision. PeopleSoft Update Images 46 and 47 offer two features requested by customers that provide flexible options for reimbursement of expense reports and cash advances. In PeopleSoft Update Image 46, we provided more flexibility for cash advance and expense report reimbursements by moving them from the Installation Options or Business Unit to User Preferences. This enables customers closely integrated with PeopleSoft Payroll to have direct deposits from expenses and payroll go to different bank accounts. In addition to the installation and business unit options, we've enabled employees to indicate how they wish to be reimbursed. This option is referenced first when payments need to be created to determine how to reimburse your employee. A tab on the employee profile allows your users to select accounts payable or payroll for expense report reimbursements and cash advances, or they can allow the system to determine the generation of the reimbursement identified either on the business unit or installation options. This lets your users choose where their payments are generated. This flexibility allows payroll to handle paychecks, but if needed, accounts payable can generate payments for expense report reimbursements and cash advances. Additional reimbursement capabilities enable users to identify which direct deposit bank accounts should be used for expense reimbursements and cash advances. On the Bank Account tab of the Expense User Profile, you can enter a set of bank accounts other than the defaults from the PeopleSoft HCM or payroll system. Here, we see the default is the bank account marked as default for accounts payable payments. When an employee indicates that expense reimbursements should be directed to an account other than the payroll account, we won't update or override the preference from expenses back to payroll. The payroll account preference remains in place. Only the expense and cash advance reimbursement accounts are used as defined in the user preferences. With these two idea space enhancements, an expenses user now has the flexibility to manage their travel-related reimbursements separately from their payroll accounts. For PeopleSoft Update Image 48, the expenses system leverages the Oracle Maps functionality, providing mapping, geocoding, and routing capabilities similar to what you can find on many commercial online mapping services. Oracle Maps autofills or suggests the location address as the start or end point, as you begin entering your point-to-point driving information. The system suggests addresses and locations for the user to choose that matches their trip. When the expense type is mileage, the page provides start and endpoint fields to indicate the distance for your trip. The Oracle Maps functionality presents options to help you find the nearest match to your starting point. You no longer have to type in a full address, specifically formatted for the system to recognize. You can also enter points of interest such as a building, airport, or airport code, or any geographic location information. Once you click the Calculate GPS Distance button, the system calculates your mileage and the reimbursement amount appears. You can choose to see a map with route information displayed on the left side of the screen. Let's take a look at how you can link a wallet entry to an existing expense report line. You may have entries in your wallet not linked to an expense report, but they should have been. This can occur when the wallet entry from your credit card feed came in after the expense report was processed. You can also use this capability when you have multiple wallet entries for the same date, amount, and location, and you have a pending expense report detail line or lines that you'd like to link them to. An icon now enables you to link a wallet entry to an expense report, even if it's been approved or paid. Many customers have requested the ability to clean up orphan wallet entries from the corporate credit card feed. Use the Wallet Entry Page More option to access the Link option. Whether an administrator is doing the cleanup of an employee's wallet transaction, or if an employee wants to link a wallet entry to their expense reports, they can do this easily from the My Wallet page. The Wallet Entry page displays all of the available wallet transactions that are not yet consumed on an expense report. These entries may have come into the wallet through a corporate credit card feed, the Picasso digital assistant, or manually entered to keep track of out-of-pocket cash outlays. The More button gives you access to additional actions. The Link option provides search criteria to find existing expense report detail rows that may be linked to the wallet entry. You can elect to search by different criteria. In this example, we'll search by date and expense type with a pending status. The system defaults to the date of the wallet entry and tries to find any existing, pending expense report lines that match. You can select the entry that best matches the wallet and click on the Link button to associate the wallet entry with the expense report detail line. If an administrator is doing a cleanup of the wallet on behalf of expense users, the administrator can broaden the search results by selecting the expense type amount option. The date parameters have become input fields to select a range of expense types and amounts to manage. Note that by changing the expense report status from pending to submitted, you can link wallet entries to expense reports submitted for approval. Escheatment is the process of transferring unclaimed property to the state. For a PeopleSoft system, this can mean uncashed expense or cash advance payments to employees or contractors that have been unclaimed for a long period of time. Prior to PeopleSoft Update 48, when a payment was escheated in accounts payable, the expenses system was unaware of the transaction. With PeopleSoft Update 48, the Updated Process Expenses Run Control page checks the accounts payable system for any escheated expenses payments. Using the Expense Processing page, you can select the Escheat Payments option. The system generates accounting entries to reverse the liability and expenses and updates the status of the expense report header to indicate the payment was escheated. We also close the loop in accounts payable by updating the accounts payable payment record to indicate the expenses system has recognized the escheatment by setting the post-cancel status to posted. These expenses features provide a better user experience. In addition, your organization can implement and configure better travel and expense policies. For more information, go to peoplesoftinfo.com.